If you're a business owner and you have team members that you want to delegate to, then using shared tasks is absolutely critical to you. And using a collaborative task management system really gives you the ability to make sure that shit gets done. And so for us today, we're going to be talking about Google Tasks and how you can use shared tasks inside of the Google ecosystem in your Google Workspace account to be more productive with your team. And that's my slide for getting shit done. So let's move on to the next one. Google's got a pretty varied history of tasks, and that's because Google have been pretty slow in developing their tasks feature. For many years, people have asked, how can I use Gmail to effectively, or how can I use the Google ecosystem to effectively get work done? And Google created a very, very rudimentary task system in the old days of Gmail. And I had to dig around for a screenshot of this. You could literally create one task per email, and it would create a task there. But there was nowhere else that you could access those tasks. And I think there was like a browser hack once upon a time that you could access those tasks, but it didn't really go anywhere from that. Then Google started doing a little bit more development on them. And you can see this is actually a third-party task, but this is the more kind of modern designed Google Tasks. And eventually they've now got to the point of putting tasks inside your Gmail. And so your tasks now live inside your Gmail. They're on the right-hand side of your Gmail. And that's basically part of Google's like have everything in Gmail feature. I even noticed that lately they've put your contacts now on the right-hand side, right along Google Keep and your calendar, because Google want Gmail to be the one home for absolutely everything for you. Now, one of the most recent features that Google have released is the ability to add tasks inside of chat. And so when you are in a room in chat, if you see there, you can go to files and then to tasks, you can actually create shared and collaborative tasks inside of your room. And that allows you to share that task with everyone who's got access to the room. So if you've got a particular team and you want to have some tasks delegated out to the team, then you can use this feature. Pretty darn handy. Now, this is a big step in the direction of Google starting to help out with teams getting more work done collaboratively, because Google have really mostly been about document creation, communication, file storage. They've never really got into the space of, I would say, productivity, and getting tasks collaborated with your team can help you do some pretty cool things. Now, we've been big proponents of recommending third-party tools like Trello and Asana, and we've even demoed Monday.com in the past as well. But each of those tools has, let's say, the friction for your team that they have to go outside of their normal workplace to another app. Now, if you're running a large company and you've got a lot of sophistication in your processes, then I'd certainly recommend you consider using a dedicated task management system. And Asana is our recommendation for that. We're also Asana partners, so we can help out with discounts if you're interested in a paid plan. And you can check out other videos on our YouTube channel about going into the details on Asana. But if you're a smaller team and you're just getting started with tasks, or maybe right now you're using a whiteboard for your tasks, then Google Tasks might be something that is interesting for you. So let me take you through some of the available features for Google Tasks as they exist right now within the Google ecosystem. We've got features such as the ability to add a task in a room. And what I love about this is it instantly gives visibility to everyone working on that team. Now, one of the great things about this is if you're already using a room for chatting with your team members, having the tasks right there in the same window makes things nice and easy. And when someone creates a task, it's going to post it into the chat. And so that's kind of like, again, one place for everything. Now, I've been a fan of using the right tool for the job, but I'm also a fan of keeping things simple. And so this might be enough for your team to get done what they need to get done. So you can do the basics with a task, like, you know, setting who's responsible for it and then creating a assignee. And that person who's assigned to that task is actually going to see the task appearing inside their Gmail, which is pretty cool. And so I had Angel create a task for me here. You can see it's go live on Facebook. It's due today, and then here it shows up as part of the attract team, which is what we call the room for our marketing team. And so automatically we've got my tasks appearing inside my Gmail. Now, you can't do much more than that. Create a task, assign it to someone, and then they see it appear in their tasks. And that's kind of all we've got to work with right now. So it's still a rudimentary system. You can create subtasks for your own individual tasks, but right now you can't create subtasks for your team members when you assign a task in a room. So let's say you've got a project, you're a construction company, and your project is to build a house. And you've got multiple different stages in building that house, and you've got different, let's say layers of responsibility for each of the subtasks, but you've got a project manager who kind of sits across the whole thing, and so they want to be the owner of the parent tasks. That's just not going to work inside something like your Gmail or inside the rooms as they are currently implemented. Although I can see that Google are doing pretty well at helping teams who maybe only have a couple of basic things that they're agreeing on each week to make it easy to drop some tasks right into where you're already working. I'm a big fan of keeping things simple. And so if right now you don't have a task management system, or you're deciding to use something like a whiteboard or still pen and paper for your tasks, or maybe you're emailing things inside the office and you're using that as your task management system. Well, that may be something to, you know, consider using Google Tasks rather than using nothing or using a tool that is less useful. Now, the age-old question is then, well, would I use Google Tasks versus using something more dedicated for task management, like a tool like Asana that we've recommended in the past? Well, you would step up to something like Asana if you've got a higher volume of projects that you're doing in your business, or more levels of project sophistication. If you want to do things like time billing or completely remove internal emails inside your business, a shared task management system like Asana, which has things like timelines and Gantt charts and assignees and followers and a communication flow in there that really helps you to reach, you know, Asana, I hate to drop that in there, but it's a really, really excellent tool at making sure that projects progress. Asana's also got a great notification system, which notifies you only of projects and tasks that you're following. And we've used Asana to completely remove internal email inside our business. And it means that we can do multiple projects at the same time. We literally run hundreds of customer projects at any one time concurrently. And we've got all of our strategic projects in there as well. Check out our other videos on our channel if you're interested to learn more about Asana. Now, one question that I get quite often is, well, Pete, is there a potential for this to disappear? Google creates all these great apps and all these great ideas, but from time to time, they actually kill things off. And that's a great question, because my response to that is typically that applications that make it into the core suite of Google apps tend to stick around. And by that, I mean something like Google Jamboard, because it's now a core suite and it's supported by Google as part of their core suite of Google Workspace. That one's going to stick around. Something like Google Draw, even though it's not fantastic inside of Google Drive, is part of the core suite of Google Drive. So that one's going to stick around. Now, Google Tasks aren't their own service. They're just a part of Chat and a part of Gmail. I don't expect Google to remove them at all. I would say that would be highly unlikely, but there is the possibility that development might stall, or they don't really develop or, you know, create a more sophisticated product from here on out. So I would say right now, watch this space with Google Tasks. There's absolutely no reason why you wouldn't use them if it's going to be useful for you. If you've got more sophisticated needs, I probably wouldn't wait around for Google to build out any features anytime soon, because wherever their attention is where their development tends to go. And that can sometimes be sporadic, moving between different tools and applications. Now, if you're a small business owner and you're wondering how we might be able to help, there's heaps of ways where you can get a bunch of value for your Google Workspace account working with IT Genius. For one, if you're interested in learning where you're at on the growth roadmap and working with our team on a map session to get some guidance on what technology strategy is most important to you, number one, make sure you've checked out the playlists on our YouTube channel. We've got a playlist for each stage of business with heaps of valuable info. But if you're interested in chatting to our team, jump onto our website and you can get yourself a free consultation if you qualify to chat to our team and help out with your technology strategy. Next up, if you're an existing Google Workspace offer and you want a bunch of free goodies, consider our transfer in offer. We have access to a free Google Classroom with professional training for your Google Workspace account. And this is designed for you and all of your team to get up to speed on everything you need to know about using all of the available features in Google Workspace to the best of your ability and to get the most out of your investment in this amazing suite of tools. We've got not only the actual training videos, but we also have a whole curriculum and program so that your staff can be certified by us in Google Workspace. And so we just want you to make this a part of your onboarding process. And so we give this to free for anyone who switches their licenses to us. So when you transfer your licensing to us, it doesn't cost you any extra because we charge the same amount that Google does. You get a little bit of limited free support from our team. We'll also do a DNS check to make sure that you've set up your DNS records correctly, DKIM, DMARC, SPF, all of those funny records that you've got to have right in your domain name to make sure that your emails get properly delivered. We will make sure that we do that for you. And that is just part of our service to check and make sure that everything is set up correctly. If you're interested in that, head along to itgenius.com/transfer. If you haven't already transferred in your billing to us, that would be awesome. itgenius.com/transfer. If you need any help, drop a comment below this video. I will I'll endeavor to answer those as much as possible. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Take care.